गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज द सेकंड क्लास फॉर आईपीओ 1 ब्लॉक नंबर 2 एंड द टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू सब्जेक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल बिहेवियर। एज यू नो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड हाउ फार the particular organization is suitable for a in different cope up with the different situations. In such scenario, in addition to particular subject, in today's class I am presenting regarding the organizational behavior and perception and learning and culture related subjects. Now I am presenting my slides and I hope you may enjoy in the particular subject. My dear students, this is the MCO 1 block 2 and today's topic is organization theory part 2, that is, and myself Dr. Durga Madhav Mahapatra, lecturer in commerce, Fakir Mohan Autonomous College Baleswar, and counselor of Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. But today's class, there are four topics are there: Unit 4, Unit 5, Unit 6, and Unit 7. In the Unit 4, the topic is overview of organizational behavior, and Unit 5 is the individual behavior and learning, and Unit 6 is the perception, and Unit 7 is the attitude and values. These are the very important topics are there, and we have to cover within the stipulated time period. And the first unit 4 topic is the introduction or overview of organizational behavior. In previous class, we have already covered the concept or meaning of organization. As I am already stated, organization means it is a place where two people work together or to achieve some goal or achieve some objective. Or every organization has a separate objective is there, mission is there, vision is there, core values is there. If you talk about Infosys is a good company, why it is a good company? There is some sort of qualities is there. In terms of quality means, in the yesterday newspaper in Times of India, one article appears that Infosys is, TCS is appointed 40,000 engineers, software engineers in a particular company. Because it is a one type of message to our society that they create the employment opportunities. But here I'm talking about the organizational behavior, means you have to study the behavior of the persons in a particular organizations. Some persons are angry, some persons you may say some persons are cool, or you may call some persons are very khadus in nature. It means, this is a Hindi term, khadus. It means everybody wants to understand the behavior of the others. So the particular person reacts in a certain situations. Sometimes you ask your colleague that what about the particular situations? If he is in cool mind, he answer in a better way. If he is in angry mind, he answer a wrong approach, he behaves. It means it is indeed to know about the behavior of the persons. Means the organizational behavior means to study the human relations with the other persons. Or you may call it as there is a different structure of organizational behavior is there. Structure means the people is there. One stakeholder is a people. Another stakeholder is a structure. Another stakeholder is a technology, and last structure is the environment. There are four parts of of approaches as regards to organizational behavior. One is people, we understand the people. Then we understand the structure of the organization. Then we understand the technology in present day world. Without technology, and technology is an enabler, and then only we can understand the technology, which type of technology the particular organization can adopt. And the technology that allows the people to do more and better work for a in the present scenario. You see, in a different organization, they are adopting the computerization, and somehow you may see in the particular newspaper, there are lots of new technology are coming, like as a artificial intelligence, machine learning. The in this way, the organizational performance and productivity and efficiency can endures to with a greater level of height. But I may pointed out that another one is environment. I'm talking about environment means environment is divided into two parts, internal and external environment. There are certain factors are there through which can influence, and these are called as a, you may call as a forces which influence the organization. You see in my slide, there is a two types of environmental forces are there. One is direct, another one is indirect. If you talk about these forces, these are the stakeholders of the particular organization. I'm talking about stakeholder. It means they are to be maybe called as a customer, maybe called as a suppliers, competitors, or labor market, or any type of regulatory agencies. If you talk about regulatory agency, if you look at banks, the regulatory agency is RBI. If you look at insurance companies, the regulatory agency is IRDA. If you look at the share capital market, the regulatory agency is SEBI is there. It means the SEBI or IRDA or RBI can enforce their regulatory way of planning to the changes the environment in the particular organization. Means, and some of the main indirect forces are there. You may call it as a economic, you may call it as a technological, you may call it as a socio-cultural and political, as well as international environment. In such scenario, you see, in American political scenario, the changes, automatically it is directly or indirectly impact upon the sum of the sector. For example, if the American President Biden some regulatory changes in visa, then it is directly or indirectly affects the IT sector, information technology sector, and in this connection, the behavior of the person also changes. So that I'm pointing out that there is a four pillars of organizational behavior. One is people, another one is structure, another one is technology, and third one is environment. My dear students, if anyone asks you what is organizational behavior and what is the short name of organizational behavior, you may call it as OB, your answer should be to know about the behavior of the persons in the organization, and you have to understand the person so that the efficiency or the it can be managed properly. And if you go through this in a detailed way, in my slides, you see in people, structure, technology, and some of the environment, which are forces to change the behavior of a person. And one definition by the Keith and Davis, they discuss that understanding the human behavior in an organizational environment, and it can shed light on the whole complex of human factor. Shed light means it is a throw light upon the to study the behavior, and certain causes are to be identified how the behavior of a person will be changes, and that affects and according to this behavior and how what is the performance of the work is there. And that correlation between the behavior and performance of the work is indeed enough to judging a present day world. In such a scenario, if you talk about scope and nature of scope of the organizational behavior, that is, it is a one type of interdisciplinary approach. My dear students, what do you mean by interdisciplinary? It means, suppose you are the student of commerce and arts is there and science student also is there, and they have some study of economics, anthropology and some other subjects, political science, psychology, sociology. These are called as behavior, means it is a mixture of all theoretical approach. And it is an applied science also, means advancement of study with psychological behavior, to know about psychological behavior of a particular persons. Another one is behavioral approach to management, concerned with the environment. It is directly, indirectly enforced with the environment. And it is a contingency system, and that is system means it is a process is there, people is there, through which the behavior also changes. And it is, has a value centered, and different other levels of analysis you can make, like as the individual behavior you can analyze, interpersonal behavior you can analyze, group behavior you can analyze, and group dynamics of behavior you can analyze, and through which you can study the better way of understanding the people, or better way of understanding the workers, better way to understanding the managing the people in your organization. For example, and the best example is the, if you see in the Big Boss, there is a certain people have to be kept together in a particular room, and in a 30 days or 40 days, how their behavior is changes, that is the best example of organizational behavior, of approach, how they think, how they behave in a particular group dynamics. My dear students, if you talk about the genesis of organizational behavior, where it is started, it means it is just, it is not started, it is just like a collaborative of different disciplines. If you talk about discipline, psychology is there, you can study the psychological behavior of a person or a membership or small groups. Sociology is there, you can study the social behavior relation with the correlate with the society and social groups. And if you study the social psychology, it also examine the interpersonal behavior. Means social psychologists also check out the individual responsiveness to change, and that change of effects which can directly impact upon the performance of a company. Another genesis of one part of interdisciplinary approach is anthropology. Anthropology is concerned with the study of human mankind or study of the behavior as a whole. It means in such a situation, some attitudinal problems, some comparative values, and some cross-cultural analysis you can study through the anthropology. And in this scenario, the individual culture, what type of, suppose in the particular state of Odisha, culture is different, and in a state of UP, the culture is something different. That type of study, that type of human behavioral study is covered under the anthropology. And if you talk about the interdisciplinary approach, political science is also one part directly directly affect the human behavior through politics. Mean present day world, politics also dominate the every organization in a some extent. It means the how the political scenario is changes, and in ups and downs through which the particular behavior of a person will be it's a one type of ingredient to change. And economics also, the climatic of economical condition, like as a labor market, like as a human resource planning, forecasting, decision making, budgeting, and that type of system covered under the interdisciplinary approach. Medicines, engineering, and through which these are the some of the areas which can contribute at a great deal of a relationship between the what type of relationship. If you talk about engineering, man and machine relationship is you can study. or you can study the piece rate system, you can study the motion rate system, you can measure the some of the work measurement plans or job design or compensation management. Then it is my point is there are several interdisciplinary subjects are there through which you can correlate your the human behavioral approach in the organization. Means somehow political science is affected, somehow economics is affected, somehow anthropology is affected, somehow social psychology is affected, somehow psychology is affected, somehow you may call it a sociology is affected, and that type of relationship of behind where the particular organizational behavior of a pillar can stand enough with four ways. One is people, another one is that is structure, another one is that is technology, and last one is environment. My dear students, the question is here in my mind, why I am studying the particular organizational behavior? What is the reason behind of study the behavioral approach of individuals? Means to understand the individual oneself and group of selves, or you individual of self development also, and for the personal development, motivating some way to do the task completion, and some higher relation that is called as the industrial relation, cordial relation. That is a in a particular organization, there is a unionism is there, and it is a, indeed have a top level manager have a cordial relation with the union leaders, and through which the manager should understand the what is the behavior of a union leader, how to tackle the problem. And another one is human values and ethical perspective. And it is a time to study the inculcate ourselves the some of the values in the sense of empathy and empathy and towards a good work towards others. That ethical perspective, that managing stress, that achieving material hygiene also. Managing stress and through which the you can use your emotions in a right direction, through which you can study the organizational behavior. Means certainly your answer should be to know the individuals, to know the self-development, to know the personality development, and the emotion, stress, cordial relation, IR, motivation. These are the some of the issues. These are not covered. Some other points are there. Motivations, job satisfaction, good communication, interpersonal relationship through the counseling, mentoring, goal setting, and decision making, and team building relationship is necessary. Indeed, have a particular type of organizational theory and understand the behavior of the person. Means it is indeed to have to become as a leader, or you have to study the leadership. For example, suppose you if you want to understand the Modi, how he acts in a particular or is a particular situation in a pandemic situation, so you have to study the human behavior of the leadership programs. You have to study the leadership styles, or whether they are autocratic leadership or democratic leadership, and that is the way of receiving the negotiations or to manage the conflict handling is indeed to have studied the organizational behavior. My dear students, organizational behavior, not only to study the only individualism, but also study the groupism, but also study the creativity, innovation, motivation, and learning organization also. My dear students, if you talk about in a behavior, there is some sort of labor turnover is arises in a particular organization, some dissatisfaction is arises in a particular organization, there is a tardiness is arises. Why this problem is arises? That dysfunctional behavior you can study. You have to reduce these type of dysfunctional behavior at workplace. Means if the particular labor turnover arises within a short period, then the company will not exist for a longer period of time, and that is directly or indirectly impact upon the performance of a company, or the productivity will be decreases. The here the my question is, my point is, Here you have to reduce absenteeism in the organization. You have to check out the plans for the employment turnover. You have to contribute a greater extent of level of advantage towards the employees at the level of dissatisfaction level. Means you have to study the employees, why they are dissatisfied, whether they are related to wages or salary problem or any type of problem. That type of well-beingness of approach is developed through the organizational behavior. My dear students, if you talk about goal of organizational behavior, you understand the behavior and you have to predict the behavior, you have to controlling the behavior, and that solution of approach you can change. And some of the traditional and new approaches to OBR there or organizational behavior are there. There are different theories. As I have already discussed in last class, scientific management theory, which is developed by the Taylor, and classical organization theory, which is developed by the Max Weber and Foyle, 14 Foyle plans, and human relation theory, that is by Hartoni experiments theory, behavioral science theory. These are the several theory I have already covered in the last class in the management concepts. My dear students, if you talk about the human factors become important in a success in a particular organization, you should emphasize on relationship, you should emphasize on synergy between teamwork, means team is necessary and leadership is necessary, and so you should more focus on environmental factors, you should focus on dignity of a particular person, and your continuous effort also to re-establish the organization in a right direction. It means in an organization means it is a indeed to have a, to become as a team member. But according to Robert Burnon, he has to describe a very better way in four major features characteristic to the modern organizational behavior. Means four features. What are the four features? Means positive point of human being in the work settings, or drawing a several related fields also. That type of integrative in nature or comprehensive in behavior or organization by combining the information from several different level of analysis is necessary in the modern organization behavior. Another one is individual behavior. If you talk about individual behavior, if I'm studying about the individual behavior or individual person's attitude, then it is a indeed to have an my behavior will change. Continuous learning is necessary. Learning, any permanent nature of behavior. If I learn something with some experience, then only I get some of the some way I am extent at a different level. And creating a good perception means your five senses you have to be open up, like as a your smell, mouth, tongue, nose, your ears, these are the eyes. Means these perception through which you can continuously, you can gather some information with different surroundings, and your positive attitude through which you can visualize on yourself, and in a particular group or in a particular when you evaluate the people, you can visualize the what is the attitude of the people and how they tackle with the particular positive attitude also creates a good harmony of effective relationship. And personality, emotion at a workplace, personality means I am sort of very much astonished with a good personality. Personality means someone is fat, someone is thin, someone is knowledgeable, someone is very intelligent. Means your feelings is something different towards the particular persons. That type of thought, that type of feelings, that type of pattern of approach is covered under the individual to start the individual behavior. And stress-free individuals and environmental attitude also an opportunity constant to demand related to in a particular uncertain situations. And my dear students, if you talk about small and large group perspective, there is a different ways are there. Group formation is there, and structure is also there, communication is also there, conflict management is also there, team building is also there, leadership is there. It means we have to form a group. we have to design a organizational structure, we have to communicate with the particular individuals in the right direction, and in a organizational perspective we have to study the organizational culture, we have to study the organizational climate, we have to study the organizational change, we have to study the organizational development. Means a change is inevitable. In the age of change, there is no permanent is there. There is a change in for a longer duration of period of time. There is a, suppose for example, in different companies are adopting their different technologies. Why this happens? This happens through which they are to be studied in organizational perspective. Another one is organizational culture is also developed. Culture means it is a conducive environment, good organizational climate is developed. That's the meaning of sharing of meaning with the plan change of interventions also. My dear students, another topic is the individual behavior in Unit 5, that is talking individual behavior and learning. In a individual behavior, what is the question is, what is learning? Learning means you can learn with the some experiences, you can learn from some of the your colleagues, and you can acquire some new skill set, or you can build up or share their leverage the knowledge with how to do things in a better competition. That is learning. But in strategic point of view, that is in view of business thinking style, you also changes reflection through mistakes, so you can also changes means learning from mistakes. Means when you take a interest on mistakes, not a take interest, but also when you appear confronted with some mistakes, then you get some learning and more sensitive, more caring, more tone aggressive in behavior, through which some feedback you receive. Through learning, there are different theories of learning are there. Classical conditioning, operant conditioning, congenient learning, and social learning. If you talk about classical conditioning, there is a relation between unconditional stimulus to conditional stimulus. The question is here, what is stimulus? Stimulus means something that caused activity or developed the interest. Means what type of activity that directly impact upon the behavior of a particular person, that is called as a stimulus. Conditioned stimulus and unconditioned stimulus. For example, better example is there. Suppose in a training of an airplane pilot, one warning bell is there. That warning bell which can show the particular type of critical situation. If the plane drops, automatically the warning bell appears. And that type of like as a ghanti bajao, it means that type of stimulus approach in a through your responding nature, that is, or the changes of your behavior, is called as a classical conditioning. For example, you take medicines, or you take the medicines for your corona, or you take medicines for your fever, or you take medicine for your blood pressure. It means through medicines, your body is responding. That is also one type of example of a internal stimulus. And there is a conditional stimulus, means something conditioned, it is called conditional responses is there. An unconditional stimulus means there is a repeated linking of conditional stimulus. Means suppose something is responding and something is not responding, and that type of approach is covered under the particular classical conditioning. Another one is operant conditioning. It means this theory is developed by the Skinner, and he gave the theory of operant conditioning. For example, operant conditioning means suppose you are at an office and you do your task in a better way, in the right time you have to complete your task, means your boss is appreciate you in such a situation. You are so much happier on the particular situation because my boss appreciates me and they give some of the appreciation letter to me. That type of approach is through the one type of learning. Means your understanding to connection between the behavior and consequences by a person to learn about the situation. Means the situation is arises to learn but which can reinforce, become the you can stronger enough. And another one is all purposes. There are three component of learning theories is there: drive, habit, and reinforcement. Ye reinforcement means that is called as a feedback received from person as a result of his behavior. Sometimes your behavior is bad, your behavior is good at a some sort of situations. But if someone asks about some feedback or giving about some feedback, then you are very much astonished on that part. That is the way through you can learn. Oh, my behavior is bad. Why? Why this happens? I do not know. It is a one type of situation you have to arise. That type of perform the desired act. And sometimes your habit is also changes in a due time period, and someone person finger on your habit, and automatically, I think do so. Me, it's not my work. Means you are indulged with the particular behavior, and that type of stimulus behavior changes by the whole. Another is cognitive of learning. It means cognitive theory was given by Tolman. And they focuses the thinking about problem inside of the individual and integrating the different cues. Cognitive learning means you have to concisely you can attach to a particular learning process. Means suppose your buying behavior is something changes according to taste, habit, fashion. Certainly you go to the Reliance Trend. You go to Reliance Digital, and if you have to study something, new electronic products are come up, new dresses are to be come up, and some new things are to come up, I have to change my behavior. That type of changing of behavioral attitude is also cognitive learning. Social learning through social groups, so observations, you learn something, and the people learn by observing by the other behavior, and you can try to imbibe their behavior too because of their. You say, why not am I? Means you see at a star at a TV or a television movies, and your hairstyle, your dressing style is also changes. That time it's called as a social learning. It means your friends also, my friend is wearing such like a dress or shoe. Why not am I? That it is one way to influence by your parents also, by teachers also, by movies also, by television also, by achiever also. If someone is getting, suppose your friend is getting IAS, clear the IAS exam, you automatically, you are so much reinforced that, why not I am I? And that's called as a one type of behavioral attitude, imbalance of behavior attitude changes in through social learning. Another is there are different strategies to change the behavior. Identify the behavior, and you have to analyze the functional behavior and evaluate the and performance behavior can be changes. But several organizations, they are modified different type of program. The what means how you have to change the behavior in a particular organization, what type of modification program you have to adopt, means in a particular organization, you should look at a good attendance. Suppose at a full attendance of a employee is there, you see that there is some modification behavior program is there. Punctuality and type of non-observable behavior is arises, or reinforcement psychology arises, or ethical issues are to be implemented by the adopted by the workers' behavior. That is called as a new type of performance of employees can be evaluated. Another one is there are different opponent conditioning to change the behavior. Suppose if you performing job well, suppose you appreciate well, suppose always you appreciate someone. Yes, you have adopted such a good idea. Your idea is good. You are a positive enough. That type of positive enforcement arises to outcome of your desired behavior. Means always be positive, positive, positive. And that changing behavior of the person always in important role in a conditional behavioral approach. Another one is if you're negative, suppose, for example, the employee always follows the order of his boss, complete the task in time. He may not be harassed or criticized by his boss, but harassment of criticism is a negative enforcement. It means you are so punctual to complete the task. Another one is the extinction punishment. There are several issues are there. My dear students, in the unit 6, there is a one topic is there, perception. Perception. My dear student, perception is a topic of unit 6. The question is, what is perception? If anyone can ask me, what is perception? Anyone can answer, what is perception? Perception. My dear student, what is perception? Anyone can answer? Hello? My dear students, perception means to perceive. Perception means to take in mentally. It means perceive. You have to perceive somebody or your feelings towards a different situations. Or suppose Baron defines that selects or organizes or interpret the inputs in sensory receptors. It means perception means I perceive he is a fat person. I perceive he is a thin person. I perceive he is a intelligent. I perceive he is a good at work. That type of interpretation or process through which the stimuli that transmitted into psychological experience. My psychology on a particular situation that the person is good at mathematics. And this is called as a take it mentally or to aware about the senses. But if you talk about process of perception, there are different stages are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. One means the perceptional inputs, means all stimuli environment which can directly impact upon the perception. Stage 2, and that is digital perpetual mechanism throughout, and the perpetual output is there. This is the way through you can study the perception. And the perception is influenced on 3 sets of factors. Factor 1, factor 2, and factor 3. Factor 1 means your perceptual value. Perceptual variables. What are the perceptual variables? Attitude, motives, interest, experience, expectation. Your expectation is high. In a particular exam, I hope my exam is good, but I have secured a 92% in the particular exam. But my person, but what I am getting, that is the one of the important aspect of to study the criteria. But another one is target of the following issues. A target means some of the personal characteristics or some of the nobility of the target, some of the sounds of the target, size of the target, background of the target, status, physical appearance. I am always talking about physical appearance. Means, oh, Shah Rukh Khan is a good star and he is a very good actor. It means through physical appearance, you are so much influenced. And that's your perception. And sometimes you see at a Tata company, you see that the size of the market size of the Tata company is something different. Means higher market share is there. If Jio is a higher market share, or you may call that through online, the Flipkart is the number one or Amazon is the number one. It's your perception, but my perception is something different. And sometimes some issues are contested in a social context, such as organizational role and location, time, and time. There is some of the time also one of the important factor you have to perceive in a particular situations, and that is called as a situational variables. But the question is, what are the barriers to accurate perceive? What are the barriers is there? What are the problems you are confronted with the particular type of perception? The one is stereotyping. Stereotyping means someone is judging something and your group is judging something, but your generalization of world is something different from your group, and that is a wrong conclusion you can approach. That is a stereotyping. Halo effect means there is a biasness. Your biasness, if some person is good, but your biasness of approach, that you are so much influenced on some factors, you said, nah, he is bad or she is bad. It is a one type of single characteristics of individual. It is not a general characteristics. That is called as a general impression. And something similar to me of effect. Similar to means if sometimes you perceive in a similarities or dissimilarities, you cannot distinguish in yourself. That is called as a tendency for the people to perceive favorably to others. Selective perception, distortion, and it is a distortion that what we see, something we encounter the data, there is a wrong approach is there. So, that accident is happened, but some people say 3 persons are died in a particular type of accident, but actual scenario, only 1 person is died. So that type of encounter, your encounter with the particular data, some type of misfiguration is a misfigure interpretation is arises. That is called a self-concept of distortion. Another one is theory of attribution. What is the theory of attribution? Means when an individual observes the behavior or determine where intentionally or externally caused. In intentionally caused means individual behavior is intentionally or personal control of individuals, or externally, which can individual has no control to outside. That is some distinctness is there, some consciousness is there, some consistency approach is there. And some managerial uses of perception is there. What type of, suppose you are watching the TV and you see the particular advertisement. In a particular advertisement shows that if you use this particular soap, you have no your face will be so much look at a very glory, and that is a one type of selective attention to help the maximize the information. That is a shape, size, brightness of able to attract the attention of prospective customers. That is related to marketing only. And if you talk about safety, some of the messages are to be arises, that is called as signal words, hazards. Suppose suppose in a particular road, some signals messages are there. Arrow mark is there and some cross sign is there. What does it mean? It characterizes the attention to getting. Means through red light, you stop. And through comprehensive level of conscience, through you can study in a better way. And managing impression, what's your impression on mind to others? That's it's important other way to managing. And building corporate images. Sometimes you are a positive impression, some corporate images, some individual, some organization, some positive impression is there. And that is, and managing the performance through self-fulfilling prophecy and self-fulfilling the prophecy through which resulting of expectation you can arise. So that is the way you can judge the employee loyalty, self-assessment of the individuals, and you can check the positive attitude, negative attitude, submissive nature, aggressive nature, submissive and aggressive. Some individuals are very much submissive. Yes, sir. And some persons are aggressive in nature. No, it's not my duty. So that is the way through which you can perceive in a different way. And if you look at a share market, some unethical practices are going on. And unethical practices, someone person is look at this unethical practices. And that's called as whistleblower. Whistleblower in a, and he put the light upon the particular dark. And that may perceive in a ethical of goods by one. That he is also called as perceived as a troublemaker by the others. Means this is another one is there are different developing the perpetual skills is there. And Johari window is a one perpetual skill. That is Johari window means joy, loot and hari ingam, which is developed. That is J. Joy means Johari window. It represents the combination of first names. Johari window is a one type of technique. You look at yourself only. It is just like a window. You look at yourself. Do not look at others. It means that technique says, I know the self. I do not know the self. And I know the self about me. I do not know the self about me. It means I know the self. I know my ability. I do not know my ability, or others do not know my ability, or others do not know about my ability. And that type of four parts, which is a cross connecting of a matrix situation, is arises through perpetual sex skills of individuals. That's a concept of Johari window. My dear students, and last topic of the this class is unit 7, that is attitudes and values. Attitude, sometimes you have to be mixed with your friend, and some friend is asking something, but automatically your feelings that he is not responding at all, or she is responding, not responding at all. It means you always said there is some problem of attitudinal problem is there. Means your feelings, your beliefs that determine the behavior of a person. What type of person? He is a very angry person. It means he's responding of words like as angry. And that may be attitude, may be positive attitude, may be negative attitude. And that may be a favorable attitude, favorable behavior, and unfavorable behavior. Sometimes you see at a particular, you go to the particular shop and you see there are different products are to be kept place in a particular similar line of in a particular shop. You see one written is there, made in Japan, made in India, automatically. Oh, made in Japan. It means technologically sound country, so that the particular product may be good. You look at the Samsung, you look at the LG, which is a Korean company. Automatically your mind state of mind always favors towards this product. This is called a one type of reliability. And my dear student, there are three components of attitudes are there. Evaluative component, cognitive component. Evaluative, how do you feel about this product? Cognitive component or attitude, how do you believe this product? And behavioral product means according to the predisposition to act a certain way, that is behavioral component. It means, yes, Hawkins is maybe the good. Sahara company, Sahara, Hamara Sahara. This is a way your behavioral component is arises into study the particular company, particular organization, particular people, the group, objects. Another one is some of the functional, important functions as to the individuals are there. Adjustment is necessary. People always adjust with the or cope up with the different situations, different relations. And to attract or to harmony of a good relationship, adjustment is necessary. And you can defensive of ego. And this, your ego or self-image should be protected, or ego should be defensive. And another one is value expression is there. Your core value will be developed and knowledge about the work is there. And there is so much process of formation of attitude is there. Social learning. And social learning is through which you can change your attitude also. You can acquiring attitude from others. We are living in a particular society. In a society, there are different caste, creed, people are there, and through which we can study the others' behavior. He is a Marwadi. It means there is some sort of cultural differences is there. And he is a Muslim, some cultural differences there. But the harmony is only one. We live together. We live together in a particular society. And that's called as a direct experience also, real life examples also, through which you can change. And there is a process of change in attitude is there. What are the process? Now, attitude through perception, our cognitive dissonance, and methods of affecting the attitude. If you talk about in traditional approach, through source, it can communicate or sender, message, target audience, through which you can develop, you can change, you can left in a better way of changing the approach. But then cognitive approach is also developed. Means what people think about the particular appeal of appearance. Suppose in a good film is come up in the particular Indian cinema. Automatically, your cognitive approach is, your cognitive approach is to him, and your attitude towards to purchase the ticket at a higher price. And that is a different type of peripherals, or that is a different type of likelihood model is there. That is called as a elaboration likelihood model, ELM. And there is a different distinct roots is there. And that depend upon the such a particular type of issues to target the persistence also. Central route is there, peripherals route is there. I mean, through advertisement in different types of products, some products are served utilitarian and some people buy huge, and some people are discouraged to buy. Suppose, for example, one example of different way to boost up images of the users also. And cognitive approach always explains the good easier to influence, means how the people easier to influence. That is the best example of only advertising. And it is a one type of convincing arguments. How you are to convince yourself and how you are to easily influence to with a such type of situations and encountered with the particular position also. Position means, for example, some advertisement through which you can change your attitude in a different way. And the relation between the attitude and behavior, it is just some specificity. Attitude is a strength also, and the attitude is a relevance also, and holding various attitude in effects stronger, and accessibility, social pressure, and hold exceptional power of individual and direct experience also. But always attitude always directly influence with the work. Sometimes work is satisfaction is arises, sometimes job belongingness is arises, or job involvement is arises, or another one is the organizational commitment. I have to commit my work. It means I feel it's my organization, and it is an attitude to a reflect a greater extent of people to identify the such type of situations. It means it's my organization, I can do for the organization, and the performance level, whatever I have performed in a better way, that the organizational productivity will increase. That is called as a work related attitude. Another topic is, last topic is value. In present day world, value system is should be exist. But in a pandemic situation, some value, what a pandemic situation means, the government is provided to the workers some food grains, some of the rupees, 1,500 to the workers. Why these arises? Only it is a India as a foundation of values, and the person attitude, perception and personality which creates understanding the values. If he is a good, it means he has on some value. If she is good, it means he has on some value. And some type of judgmental element is there, good, desirable, right. And value means it is a, you may call it as a, you like him, you dislike him, your viewpoints is something different, and that's also called as a values. But there are different types of values are there. What are the types of values? The G.W. Alport and his associates identify the six types of values are there. Emotional values, societal values, political values. Means social values, highest value to love people. Economical values, emphasis towards a good and a good particular practicable of useful of the particular product. Religious value, there is a some understanding of some type of experiences of unity of experiences. Mean there are the, in present day world, value organization should be created. Means the trust the people, respect the people, treat the people with as a part of the organization, encourage the people, promote the people, and authenticate the people also. Another one is the use of authority and networking. Encourage the people, encourage willingness. So these are some issues which are conflicted with some of the values. My dear student, In today's class, we have already discussed regarding values, discussed regarding learning, discussed regarding some of the organizational concepts and theories. But whatever it may be, we have to study the individual behavior. We have to study the attitude of the behavior. We have to study the behavioral concept, like the people. Another one is the structure of the organization. Another one is technology, and last one is the environment through which it can influence the change of attitude, change of behavior, and change of other way of terms of business. And in this connection, I want to see the in this particular situations, the particular organization can develop in a better way and through which the organization can stand enough. My dear students, if you have any question, you can put into the particular chat box and you can ask me in the chat box and I can answer, and I can surely distribute my PPT through WhatsApp and through other, if you give me the WhatsApp you may collect my WhatsApp number, then you through which you can get the particular PPTs. Or if you have any question, you can ask me directly or through WhatsApp. And someone says, Sobhagya Khatua says, own opinion about someone. Yes, yes. Perception means own opinion. Sobhagya Khatua, own opinion about someone. Another one is Praveen Kumar says ability to notice something. Yes, it is a very good answer regarding perception. And Sobhagya Khatua says Harshad Mehta. Yes, Harshad Mehta's come. Harshad Mehta's come 1992. And there is a unethical issues and practices he has done in the year of 1992 in the Indian capital market. These are the some of the issues which can be undertaken the in a particular organizational behavior. Or any question, any doubt, or otherwise I can complete my the particular topic. Anita Das or Ankita Ghosh, any question from your side? Samir Mahapatra. Okay, thank you, my dear students. And in the next day at the same time, 8 to 9, and another topic we can cover the MCO 1, and that is the related to your subject, organizational behavior. Abhismita Rana, thank you once again. Now I am stop my recording also. Thank you. Your class is amazing. Yes, Sobhagya Khatua, thank you. And it's a great inspiration on my part.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Thank you.